how to manage your contacts in Gmail, as told by your favorite Gmail CRM and Google Workspace experts, NetHunt. Press those subscribe and notification bell buttons to get more content like this. By the end of this video, you're going to have the tools to add contacts automatically and manually, group them together, manage the dead ones, merge the duplicates, and sync them with your favorite Gmail CRM. Adding contacts to Google is easy. Head to contacts.google.com and you see this, Google Contacts. Simply find the plus button and fill out all the necessary information about your contact that you need. Generally, a first name, last name, company, and a means of contact is absolutely essential data. Preferably, there's going to be an email address in there if you're reaching out to them on business purposes. Similarly, you can save yourself a lot of hassle and automatically add contacts to Google when you email them. You just need to make sure that you have that setting enabled in your settings. Head to Gmail and open Mail Settings in the top right corner by hitting the cog icon. Then hit the See All Settings button. Open the General tab and scroll down to find Create Contacts for Autocomplete. The top option adds recipients to Google Contacts automatically. Scroll down to the bottom and hit Save Changes. You can also apply this setting so it works across wider Google, adding contacts from places like Hangouts and Chats whenever you interact with them. Hit your profile picture on the Google homepage. Choose Manage Your Google Account. On the top navigation bar, click the option People and Sharing. On the Contacts panel, click Contact Info Save from Interactions. Turn on Save Contact Info when you interact with people. Next, labels. Google Contact Labels is Google's contact segmentation feature. It categorizes contacts and groups them depending on one main label you give to them. For example, I might label my contacts by their job position or whether they're a decision maker in their business. This means I can send hyper-personalized content to help their decision be made. If you want to know more about audience segmentation, check out the link to the article in the comments. To label your contacts, go to the contacts homepage and hit Add Edit Contact. Find the label section next to Add Edit Contact and choose a preset label or create your own. From there, you'll be able to email a specific segment of prospect, lead, or customer by their set label. For example, if I label my contacts based on the industry they're in, I can give them specific personalized information and discounts to give myself the best chance of conversion. But if you're firing out red hot email campaigns, you don't want them to be sent to the same person twice. That's annoying, unprofessional, and a one-way ticket to unsubscription. Like any good database, you need to keep your contacts clean. If nothing else, duplicates are bad news for your email metrics. Delete them with Google's handy little button. So we're on contacts.google.com, and on the left, I find Merge and Fix. In the top right, click Merge All. Or you can review each duplicate and click Merge on the ones that should be correctly merged. But it's worth noting that you can't merge contacts that are saved in different Google accounts. Like, you don't want any duplicates, you also don't want any dead contacts in your emailing list. Now, there's no official way of removing dead ones from your list, but there is a cheeky little Google hack that exposes the fakers. We recommend you validate your mailing list when a bunch of new recipients has been added, or if your bounce rate is 2% or higher. Also, you might want to look at it if you have low open rates. Validate your Gmail mailing list by sending generic content to all contacts. Offer a small discount, run a competition, or anything you can think of that can validate your mailing list without seeming unimportant or unsubscribable. Despite how eloquently and exhaustively I've just explained the Google platform's capabilities, there are limitations. Take lead generation, for instance. You can use forms and spreadsheets and spend time copying and posting data, but that's not efficient. NetHunt Gmail CRM integrates directly with the systems that your business already works with for lead generation, like LinkedIn, for example. By pressing this handy little button that magically appears when you download the extension from the web store, you can glean all that juicy data you need from a lead's LinkedIn profile. Then you'll be able to see all that data in your CRM dashboard and get them onto your pipeline. Another big tick for NetHunt is that it's easy to bring all your contacts over from Google Contacts. In fact, you can sync the two systems to have the same data in real time. Bring all your Google contacts into NetHunt by heading to NetHunt settings and click on the Google Contacts Sync tab. Choose a Gmail label, some Gmail labels, or all your contacts to sync. Hit sync and all the contacts will be synced to the destination folder you've selected. You can find that in the data enrichment settings. So that's all from me today. This has been part one of our Gmail hack series on how to use Gmail as a contact management platform. Stay tuned for our next video in the series, where you'll learn everything you need to know about that bastion of professionalism, creating and applying an email signature in Google Gmail. And if you've got any cheeky little Gmail hacks, let us know in the comments below. Like and subscribe. If you haven't already, head to community.nethunt.com and get in on the conversation over there. And I'll see you in the next video. Over and out.